When you tune the trumpet, basically what you're doing is you're changing the length of the instrument. The longer an instrument is, the lower its pitch will be. Now, what we're doing is we're going to change the pitch or the length of the instrument a very, very small amount. So if you can see right here, my slide is pulled out about maybe a not even a half an inch, about a quarter inch. And it's very, very difficult to hear these differences in pitch. I don't think I understood the concept of tuning early. It's a pretty easy concept to understand. But to actually hear it was something very different. It was very difficult for me. I don't think I really got it until probably late in high school, so after maybe 6 or 7 years of playing. So if you don't hear this sort of thing right off the bat, don't worry too much about it. But there are ways you can work on your ability to tune to help you do that, hopefully a little faster than I did. So the best way to mess with this is to get a tuner. And with the tuner, you can play into the tuner and it will tell you what note you're playing. It will give you the note in concert pitch, which is going to be a whole step lower than the note you're actually playing. So if I played a G on here, the tuner would tell me it's an F. It's a concert F. So anyway, messing with the tuner will help a lot. If you play an F or a C, an open note on the trumpet, it will tell you how far away from standard pitch you are. And usually that's with the note A equaling 440, I think it's hertz, megahertz, I don't remember, I think hertz. Anyway, A 440. So that's basically it for tuning. You can mess around with this by pulling the slide almost all the way out and then pulling it in gradually and listening to the difference in pitch. Tuning to another person is another matter entirely. We'll get to that in a different post. What I'd like to talk about more in this one is notes that are out of tune on trumpet. Probably the very worst note is C sharp, the low C sharp, 1, 2, and 3. That's a very, very sharp note. And in order to get that note in tune, you always need to kick your third valve slide out. Now, I have a little trigger here, and I've actually used some elastic too to help it snap back a little more quickly, and so I don't lose the slide. And so I'm using my third finger to move the slide a little bit out. Now, I know exactly where in tune is, both because I've looked at a tuner and because I'm listening. So whenever I play a C sharp and whenever you play a C sharp, you should kick that slide out. Now, you can also kick out this first slide. You can also kick out this first slide. This also will lower the pitch of the note. Or you can kick both of them out a little bit. Whatever makes the most sense to you and is the easiest. If those parts of your instrument are frozen, you need to fix them. Because it's a very important, it's a very out of tune note. So listen to the difference between it open, the C sharp without the compensation of the slides and then with. It's a very slight difference. I hope you could hear that. So that's the very worst note on trumpet, that C sharp. Another bad one is the D, just a half step above that. It's also sharp, and you do the same thing. So I'm kicking my slide out. In order to get that note in tune. If you can't hear that, don't worry about it too much right now, but you should get yourself in the habit of using that slide kick for the C sharp and the D. There are other notes that are out of tune on trumpet too. Probably the most notorious one after those two is the fourth space E. That one is usually flat, and notes are harder to lip up than they are to lip down. So often a good way to do that one is to play it 1 and 2, and if that's sharp, which it will tend to be, is using your slide again to lower the pitch. That way you don't have to use your chops, it won't get you tired, and you'll be in tune. Good luck.